Okay, so now kita nak tengok condition di mana producer, sometimes producer bayar lebih, sometimes consumer bayar lebih tax, yeah, the amount of tax. What is actually causes of this? Yeah, apa yang menyebabkan producer bayar lebih dan consumer bayar lebih? Kita nak tengok kepada elasticity of demand and supply. Right, so the elasticity, the price elasticity or the degree of responsiveness of price elasticity of demand and supply that actually influence, yeah, the amount of tax paid by both producer and consumer. So kita tengok the first example, figure 4.11. So you can look at page 109. Kita tengok diagram A dulu, yeah. So, this condition berlaku kalau demand less elastic than supply. Yeah, demand less elastic than supply atau kita panggil sebagai demand is inelastic. So, bila demand itu inelastic, demand curve is steep. Yeah, kita kena tahu steep di mana dia agak menegak begini. Yeah, menegak daripada macam ni, dia menegak sedikit. Okay. So, what is the effect of tax lah, incidence of tax, yeah. What is the incidence of tax? Jadi, for example, before tax is imposed, equilibrium price is $5, quantity is 10 units. So after government impose tax, price increase to $10, quantity reduced to 8 unit. Okay, jadi the blue shaded area itu adalah tax yang liable to the consumer and grey shaded adalah kepada producer. So by looking at this, kita tahu consumer will pay more tax when demand is less elastic. Yeah, kenapa? Because consumer are not responsive or sensitive towards price change. Macam harga petrol naik ke turun ke, still people will consume. Yeah, sebab that is there is no substitutes available. Yeah, so they have no choice. So sebab tu dia tak responsif dengan harga. So jadi dia akan membayar lebih tax. Okay. So the per unit tax paid by consumer is 5 units and per unit tax paid by producer is 1. Ya. Yeah. Macam mana dapat 5? 10 minus 5 is $5 per unit tax paid by the consumer. And then untuk producer pula, $5 minus $4 dapat $1. So all together, berapa government impose tax? 10 minus 4, $6. Yeah. So kalau kita nak kira total pula macam mana, darabkan dengan kuantiti barulah. Jadi untuk consumer tadi, $5 darab dengan 8. Yeah, 5 darab 8 dapat 40. Kemudian kita untuk producer pula $1 darab 8 dapat 8. So all together berapa total tax imposed by the government? Jadi 6 darab 8 48. So that is how we analyze for the demand less elastic than supply. Example kedua, bila demand more elastic than supply ataupun kita kata demand is elastic. So ini figure B lah, eh, figure B. Jadi kalau demand is more elastic, demand curve dia macam mana? Flatter, ya, yeah, flatter. Jadi the price before tax is $7, quantity before tax is 10 units, price after tax is $8, quantity after tax is 4 unit. Ya, jadi blue shaded area consumer bayar hanya $1. 8 minus $7 jadi $1. And grey shaded area itu paid by producer $7 minus $2, $5. Okay. So kita kata when demand is more elastic or demand is elastic, producer will pay more tax. Sebab apa? Di sini consumer are responsive towards price change. Harga barang naik walaupun sedikit, mereka, ya, consumer akan reduce the consumption in a bigger percentage. Jadi producer tak nak rugi, so dia sanggup bayar lebih untuk supaya dia tidak naikkan harga dengan terlalu banyak. Okay? So because of demand is more elastic, producer will pay more tax. So Itu contoh, dua contoh lah. Yeah. So, kita ada lagi empat condition, yeah, four condition bila di mana demand is perfectly elastic, perfectly inelastic, supply is perfectly elastic and perfectly inelastic. So, kita akan tengok next.